Thanks for staying with us. 8 former foreign affairs ministers were recognized for their contribution to this country at a gala held on August 20th at the French Veranda. The ministers are the late Hudson Tunis, as well as Sir James Mitchell, Herbert Young, Alpian Allen, Alan Cruikshank, Michael Brown, Dr. Douglas Slater, and Camila Gonzalez. Recognition was also given to the ambassadors and the diplomats who served at overseas consulates. Following a drug operation conducted by the ONDCP on Friday, August 12th, in the Big Creek and Golden Grove areas in Antigua, police arrested 3 Antiguans, 27-year-old Mark Brown, 30-year-old Cameron John, 24-year-old Makisha Henry, and Vincentian, 35-year-old Steve Brown. Police arrested the 4 after they were caught with 697 pounds of cannabis, which carries an estimated street value of $1,295,250. The drug is said to have originated from St. Vincent, sources say. According to the Brentford News, they were to be arraigned on August 16th to answer several drug-related charges. In his address at the ceremony, Deputy Prime Minister and Minister for Foreign Affairs Sir Lewis Straker said the ministers have played a significant role in the advancement of foreign affairs. Meanwhile, Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs Nathaniel Williams said the foreign ministers all served with distinction. ECCB Small Business Management Workshop Part 2 has been rescheduled to Friday 9 September 2016. Persons who have not yet registered can now take advantage of this extension. The workshop, which forms part of the ECCB Public Service Program in the region, is now set to run every Tuesday and Thursday from September 20th to October 13th. It will be held at the training room of the NIS, that is National Insurance Services NIS, which is partnering with the ECCB and the Center for Enterprise Development, ECED, to deliver the workshop. The next phase of training comes after the ECCB, in collaboration with the Center for Enterprise Development Incorporation, CED, and the University of the West Indies, successfully conduct the first part of the workshop in June that saw 40 persons completing it. The Eastern Caribbean Central Bank will launch Financial Information Month, FIM, with the unveiling of a theme song and video. This event will take place at the Eastern Caribbean Central Bank Agency Office, French's Kingstown, on Thursday, 25th August 2016, from 9:30 a.m. The general public, the media, and officials will be treated to presentations on the theme, interview with the artists, and a preview of the video along with its live performance. The event will be conducted by a video conference connecting all countries of the currency union. Residents in the Lesser Antilles, and in particular the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico, are asked to monitor the progress of a tropical wave located about 550 miles east of the Lesser Antilles. These organized shower and thunderstorm activities are expected to be produced from this development. Conditions for the system are expected to develop late this week as they move towards the Hispaniola and central Bahamas areas. Leader of the opposition, New Democratic Party, Anne Musa, said that his leadership of the party would be left up to delegates at the party's next convention. Musa has been leader of the NDP since October 2000, when he took over from then Prime Minister James Mitchell. The party so far has suffered 4 consecutive defeats under Mr. Musa, the most recent, the December 2015 elections. Party members and supporters are especially anticipating this year's convention, saying that he cannot expect to continue leading the party. Musa told Eyewitness News that he believes that the Vincentian will go to the polls in less than a year after the last vote. Honorable Anne Musa, president of the New Democratic Party, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, at a press briefing that was held at the New Democratic Party headquarters today, said, quote, "In keeping with our mission and responsibility as a mature public service institution dedicated to good governance and national development in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the New Democratic Party, the oldest continuously functioning mass political organization in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, constantly monitors the state of international affairs with specific emphasis on how they impact various parts of the world, our own vital economic and other interests as a small island developing state in the Caribbean." Coming up next, we take a look at the sporting highlights.